I don't really aspire to be like anyone. Everyone else is taken, be yourself. I get a lot of inspiration from the chefs in the kitchen, from my family. It's a family-run hotel, so we run the kitchen like it's a family as well. We're located in the heart of Somerset, Taunton. Beautiful country town. We've got over two restaurants. One is Braz, which is our bistro. It's open breakfast, lunch, dinner, 7 days a week. And then we've got our Castle Bow, which is our fine dining restaurant, our modern restaurant, which I'd kind of oversee a lot of them and do the menus with all the guys and all the people in the various positions. In Castle Bow, it's more of a special occasion restaurant where you get to go, relax, have great service. The service, the front of the house for me, I've noticed over the last few years in dining has come to the front a lot more. So the chefs come out into the dining room. We interact with the customers. It's relaxed fine dining. We try and bring a bit of our fun, a bit of our personality into the restaurant and have fun with the food. Simple, but very good, very based on classic flavors, you know, which is where we're grounded at, but modern, you know, play with things, play a twist. I'm gonna cook for you a fillet of beef. It's a Dexter fillet I'm using today. We used to use a Devon Ruby Red, so it's a beautiful small fillet of beef. I've got with it braised red cabbage, artichokes, asparagus, and a bit of truffle to finish it off. So step one is obviously sourcing your beef. We got a beautiful dry aged piece of beef. Our fillet of beef, we brush it in an aged fat. Adds more flavour to it. The hang on it is about 4 weeks, but we just go a little bit over. Because it's a smaller fillet of beef, we try not to age it too much. Dry aged, as I said, cling film a portion into a 100-gram portion. Put the beef, fillet of beef, we just pan fry it. So we get a really hot pan, seat it top, flip it over, throw in a little bit of butter, and in the oven for 4 minutes. Take it out and let it rest for as long as you cook it. That's the one golden rule when you're cooking meats, is to let it rest for as long as you've cooked it. So the garnish with this dish it's a little bit cheeky because I always find this the toughest season. It's going between, you know, the end of winter going into spring, but it's braised red cabbage. Your red cabbage is in, so it's quite boozy. Fillet of beef, make something strong to go against it. We've got artichokes, which is your spring, summer essence part, a little bit of asparagus, and then finish with a bit of truffle for some extra kick. At the center point for every one of our dishes, you know, we focus on the beef in this. We've got a title at the top, which is, you know, local beef, reared locally. Beautiful, tasty. So the main center point for this is to focus on the beef. There's a few classical flavours that go in there, you know, red cabbage, you know, boozy red wine, artichokes. But at the centre point, you'll have a beautiful medium rare piece of beef if I don't overcook it. We tend to visit our farms quite a lot and name all their animals. It's an organic farm. They're very friendly, very open. It's just a farm where you can, you know, you feel loved, the animals are loved. That comes across in the meat for me. Telling a story, carrying the story on into the restaurant, you know, mentioning James's name, it means a lot to us. Just for chefs to understand, junior chefs coming through the ranks, you know, a lot of places now buy in their loins, or they buy in us, you know, meat fat packed, or it comes pre-prepared, you know, ours comes in whole, so we get to break it down and the guys understand the whole different elements of the breakdown of a lamb or a cow, or whatever we're doing. And just, yeah, trust your instincts. Make sure you're sourcing good quality beef, whether it's from your butcher. Just ask for the best. You know, if you get the best ingredients, it's so simple to recreate what we're doing.